Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Mod Fallout New Vegas. I finally found all the containers. That was frustrating. I also got this. A little something from Project Nevada. Gives me more carry weight.
Howdy. What can I do you for?
Looks like I found all the containers you said you need.
You got everything already? Wow, that's impressive. There's one thing we need to talk about before we proceed. If you stored anything of value in any of those old lockers in the school, you need to head out and grab your gear before we move forward. Dean's going to haul those old lockers off for scrap metal and set the new ones up for you. He'll most likely do it tomorrow, so you can't forget to remove anything you want to keep. Otherwise, it's getting hauled off.
Okay, so I've
Okay, check back with me when you're ready to go.
I think he removes the dumpster too. I mean, check if there's anything. Okay, we're good.
Goddamn. Don't eat the squirrel bits, man.
Howdy. Dean's. Very well then. Listen, there's something that's been on my mind. It just ain't right having you sleep on that old filthy mattress in there. I was going to save this for later. But when Dean sets up the lockers, to take a nicer bed over for you so you can be well rested. It's the least I can do. So you'll have a much better bed and plenty of containers. Put anything in them you want to, and your gear will be perfectly safe from now on. I know it's not quite a home yet, but we're getting there bit by bit. Go get some rest, and when you're ready to go, we'll go over what we have left to do.
They ain't good.
All right. Cool. Still not doing it. Guess we have to wait 24 hours. All right.
Howdy, neighbor. How you doing?
You were going to fill me on the wiring for the school?
Yes. Luckily, the wiring in the walls is intact and ready to be tied into the new solar power system. It's pretty genius, actually, but it's still very simple. The sun charges the batteries, and the batteries power the school. The batteries are inside of a UPS, or Uninterrupted Power Supply console, that Dean's been fixing up. He tells me that everything checks out so far except for the inversion coil in the thing. It's completely burned out and needs to be replaced. Also, in addition to the coil, we'll need a small solar panel to use to charge the whole thing up.
Is it inversion coil? What's that?
Yep, it's a nifty piece of tech. The simple explanation is that the solar panel collects energy from the sun and sends it to the UPS system. The UPS system uses that energy to keep its batteries charged, but the power from the batteries is DC voltage. And, unfortunately, everything in the school runs off of AC voltage. That's why the UPS has the inversion coil, or inverter, to convert the DC to AC so it can power up the school. It converts the power, feeds it to the transfer switch, which sends the power to the main panel and on into the school.
But what about if there's no sun for a while?
Yes, excellent question. That could be a problem, could it not? Well, this system also has a backup generator that kicks in if the batteries get too drained. The generator also recharges the batteries when the UPS is offline. Everything ties into the transfer switch, which controls which power source is being used. It transfers or switches back and forth between the solar and generator power depending on which one is online.
Any idea where I can find a coil and a solar panel?
Not sure, but the only place we might have a chance of finding them would be that old solar energy facility called Helios I. Hell, I'm not even sure if you can get into the place anymore. NCR's got it on lockdown these days. Are you up for giving it a